Om Gyan Kimanasya Yananana Sadakya Chakshura Miritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
The other day, I was reading a quote of Martin Luther, who said that God did not just write the gospel in the Bible, but he also wrote it on the trees, on the leaves, on the flowers, and nature. And I liked that quote, that we cannot just limit spiritual life to the teachings of a book. Spiritual life is all around us. It is everywhere. The book is simply helping us to see it. It's not the book that is actually containing Krishna consciousness. Krishna is everywhere. The book helps us to perceive Krishna everywhere. So the real adventure is really beginning to see that. That is where it becomes exciting.
Srila Prabhupada gave us the greatest gift. And that greatest gift is exactly this vision of transcendence, that we are not this body. How many times did he say it? How many times did he emphasize it? To a point where we thought, yes, yes, we know. But do we know? Obviously, there is a huge difference between having heard transcendental knowledge and being able to repeat transcendental knowledge and to live transcendental knowledge. Transcendental knowledge is meant to be realized. Initially, we develop some faith, because we are hearing from one who is clearly showing transcendental symptoms. This is simply how Srila Prabhupada preached, on the strength of his faith. It was his faith in Krishna that impressed people. It was his faith in scripture that impressed people. And one thing that impressed people, at least we hear from testimonies, is that what impressed them about Prabhupada was that he didn't try to impress anybody. That's not so easy. That truly means we're not this body.
You carry my desire in your heart. My desire is that you really connect with Srila Prabhupada. How nice here in Vrindavan. Prabhupada on his Vyasa-san, don't you like his lions? I like his lions very much. They are kind of, they look like real lions. They have the brown color of real lions, and they are, yeah, the right size. Prabhupada's house, so many nice paintings, each telling us, yeah, so much about Prabhupada's meditation. Please connect to Srila Prabhupada.
It's wonderful if we can recite the entire Bhagavad Gita by heart. If we can even realize one verse in our heart, that's more wonderful. We can compare the Bhagavad Gita for a moment to a cookbook. And it's certainly amazing if someone can recite an entire cookbook by heart. Imagine all the recipes and a pinch of salt and, you know, and this and that. Imagine. I mean, we'd certainly give an applause if someone recites the cookbook. But if someone cooks one recipe really well, that wins naturally. So it is realization that is really what it's all about. That realization comes in that asyakta manaha, in that deep attachment to Krishna, in that our consciousness is attached to Krishna, attached to pleasing Krishna.
How to deal and face the obstacles in devotional life? By devotional service, because bhakti comes from bhakti. It is bhaktyamam abhijanati. It is through devotional service that we get bhakti. So all obstacles are overcome by devotional service.
I pray to one day love Krishna. The word love Krishna cannot be used so cheaply. How can a pumpkin from Holland just love Krishna? It takes a great effort in devotional service. It takes an effort to somehow or other sacrifice and go step by step from the initial stages of having some faith to learning to associate with devotees. How many years have I made so many mistakes in associating with the devotees? How then could I properly chant Hare Krishna and properly engage in devotional service? What to speak of anartana vritti, of the heart becoming purified? What to speak of getting some determination in devotional service? What to speak of getting some taste? What to speak of getting some attachment to Krishna? What to speak of getting ecstasy? What to speak of love? What can I speak of love for Krishna?
What I want from you is that you always, that you have a vision. Right? It is my duty to be a visionary. And what I would like is that you have a vision in life. That means that you look at your whole life and that you look, where am I going? That's what I would like. Where am I going with my life? Not just living and surviving from day to day, but I'd like to see that you just think about, where am I going with my life? And it better be to the spiritual world. And who are you taking with you? That's the question. Go to the spiritual world, and who are you taking with you? We all have different natures. Some, they like to study. Some, they like to chant. Some are very passionate and like to do things. So whatever, engage it in a way that we develop compassion, right? I want to see compassion for conditioned souls. I'd like my disciples to be very compassionate and kind. I'd like them to be oceans of mercy.
The theme entirely of the gopis in Vrindavan is pleasing Krishna. And then one day, a Krura came. And there was this chariot in front of the house of Nanda Maharaj. And then a Krura came. And then a Krura passed on the news that Krishna was invited to come. And then Krishna so easily wanted to come. And Nanda agreed. And there Krishna and Balaram went off on the chariot. The gopis, they tried to stop the chariot. Now, the question may be raised, why? Why? It was, the gopis were looking at Krishna, and it looked as if Krishna wanted to go. So, then, if they were completely surrendered to satisfying his desires, why didn't they walk in front of the chariots and throw flowers in front the whole way? Huh? Krishna wants to go, and they are stopping his chariot. Is this acting for the pleasure of Krishna? Or was there selfish desire? Were they really completely free from selfish desire when they tried to stop Krishna? He wanted to go, so help him to go. What's the problem? No, the gopis knew Krishna has gone mad. Krishna has lost it. Krishna doesn't understand what's in his own interest. If Krishna will leave Vrindavan, he cannot be happy. Therefore, we cannot let Krishna leave Vrindavan. So they did not think if Krishna leaves Vrindavan, we will not be happy. No, they thought if Krishna leaves Vrindavan, Krishna will not be happy. This is praying. There is no trace of any selfish desire. It is simply only one desire, to please Krishna. That is pure transcendence.